Now, Josh, when you were growing up, there were only four of you in your year.
Correct.
So this must feel... You must be very at ease in this scenario.
Well, no, there's five. This is absolutely a metropolis to me. I don't like it at all.
It's probably rough, though, isn't it, if you bullied at a school of four.
There was just a year. There was far more at the school. There was 25 at the school. The other thing is, because we didn't have any cooking facilities, so instead of saying here, we'd have to say packed or dinners, depending on whether we had packed or dinners. And then one child would have to note down the amount of people that said dinners and then go to the phone and phone through to the next school that had a kitchen and they would send the meals across at lunchtime.
Oh!
One night at school, his mum had sent it in with a flask of hot water and a pot noodle and it felt like space age.
I've got to say, gang, I had a pot noodle the other day. I had a cheeky one the other day.
Can I ask a question? Is this the show?
Not at all. Josh, what was your original sin?
It's not as grubby as the other two.
OK.
But I think there was genuinely a lot of... hundreds of victims.
Oh, really evil.
So I used to work at Waterstones in Manchester Deansgate, and we used to have a lot of big-name people coming in to do signings. The big one, 2004, this is.
Stormzy.
It wasn't Stormzy because he'd have been two.
OK. Skepta.
Skepta.
I'm trying to keep it Dave. Keeping it Dave. Skepta. Hmm? Skepta? Come on,
we all
Borden.
Know you're getting it fed into your ear, Mel.
We all know who Skepta is, don't we?
Sing one of their songs, Mel.
I am Skepta. I am Skepta. I am very Skepta. That one.
OK, I know who you mean.
Yeah?
Got your back, I'm there.
Come on, Josh.
Sorry.
David Beckham.
Oh!
Wow.
And he's playing in Madrid.
Stop it.
But he's obviously coming back to Manchester for one day only to do a signing of his new autobiography. So the night before, all his people come in and they're like, you know, it's like a military operation, right? The rule is, everyone goes up, they've got one book, you can only get a book signed, you can't get anything
Don't
else signed.
Push it.
And it's before the advent of the selfie. So they're going to give their cameras to a member of staff who will then, their job is take the camera, person goes up, David, say cheese, boom, pass the camera back to them, bang, bang, bang. I've got a B and A level photography, it's a no-brainer, right? But suddenly I realise I don't know how to work 80% of these cameras. But I also realised this was before you could see on a screen.
Oh.
And I don't want to piss people off. So I spent the day... People had queued overnight and I spent the day pretending I'd managed to take a photo.
Oh, no. I can't look him in the eye anymore.
To be honest, I did the same when I was a wedding photographer. It's easy.
For me, that's worse than a poo or a wank in the bath.
Yeah.
I'm sorry. I'd have been so gutted if I'd been one of those fans.
Yeah. There's genuine cruelty to
it's
that.
And there's forethought. Yeah.
I was told to come up with something, like, unforgivable.
It is.
And I did, and now you're having a go at me for it.
No, and I'm celebrating that. And I'm celebrating...
Well done. That was great, Josh. Good for you.
Josh, who might you be apologising for if that person is indeed linked to you?
Is it Chico?
Chico the singer?
Yeah.
OK.
I was once drunk at about 1:30 in the morning in a green room after a TV show.
Just to explain, the green room is the room in which people relax.
It's free drink. So we decided to start prank calling some people because there was a landline phone in the green room.
Oh, fun.
Someone... said, I've got Chico's number.
What?
You must hang around with some pretty big hitters.
No. So we dialed his number and amazingly he picked up.
Wow.
And I said, what time is it?
Of course.
And he said, it's Chico time. I got pulled over by the dibble.
The peelers.
The fuzz.
The bacon.
Too far. I got pulled over by the police for driving a double bed down the road.
Hang on, was this rag week at university?
It was at university, but it wasn't rag week.
Yeah.
To repeat a motif, it was about 1 a.m. And coming back, and there was a double bed in someone's garden.
Yeah.
We needed a double bed. Thought we'd take this. But it was too heavy to kind of walk it down, me and my friend. And so we put it down on the road, pushed it along. It had wheels. You know those beds with wheels?
Yeah.
So we were going with the traffic on the road, and then the police turned up, pulled us over.
What did the filth do then?
The Rozzers. They radioed in, and then they gave us a telling off, and insisted that we take the double bed back and return it.
To Dreams or wherever it had come from.
No, they stole it from a garden of somebody's house.
No, have you listened to any of the fucking story? Melly, are you baked?
No, it's just, you know, it's Dave and everything, so I'm just, like, chilling.
Are you aware what Dave is?